Okay, so now that I have the IMGUI stuff all sorted and that, I need to start expanding into, well, improving the rasterization, adding models, materials, and so on and so forth. But one of the first things I need to do is figure out the system for being able to put descriptor sets into place, and I'm going to start with cameras, and obviously, like you can, so that I can start doing passing information into shaders from the program via the descriptor sets and stuff, which will, in this case, take the basic triangle and start manipulating it. This basic triangle, if I can come bring it up, so I'll be able to like click drag around and be able to rotate around it and maybe move back and forth away from it. So, one of the first things I'm going to require is, of course, some kind of the basic camera structure, which of course means I'm going to no, not quite yet, actually. So I can actually build it up in here per frame data. First things first. From X and from Y, we have a view Y near Z, far Z. We're going to need a do I have GLM even in here? Not quite. Perspective. Height near far. Oh, I just do float, can I? This needs to be radians. Okay. Then we want to have the position of the camera. Quaternions for orientation. with the Vulkan data or the graphics data, which will be VK buffer. Would it be VK buffer? Probably not. It'll be the descriptor set. So I don't think I don't want to have like an individual buffer for each camera. I'm going to try to collate them into like a little pool and just generate them all together as required. Camera descriptor pool kind of thing. They'll hook into this thing. Actually, before I go into that, shaders, simple. That's an old basic thing. So we'll just kind of use, not quite. Go in here. It'll be like camera try. Which will be very, very, very similar to this. Except rather we're going to have location layout in, so. So it'll be random data. Put this down here. Layout set 0, auto binding 0, matrix 4. Run it projection view matrix times that. We're just adding just the basic uniform. And then we're going to actually also require okay, let's see if I can actually bring this in. This. I'm gonna bring it in. Okay, we do that, we load it in, then we want to be able to read in. Do I even have... No, I do not. So this is where the YAML stuff is going to start coming into play for specifying the basic data. Or, no, I wouldn't even quite need that yet, would I? It's this type. It has that. Just the one. So let's make sure we can actually, we're actually going to load it in. It's generated, good. So we got it. Got the shader module. It's loaded. Great. Okay, let's see if we can actually, if there's an issue with me actually generating this specific pipeline. Just as a thing, vertex of camera, vertex descriptor. Let's see if it's actually going to just blow apart or not. It's not even running that. Well, it didn't die. Okay. Oh yeah, because I didn't even like set anything else to die. This would be a whole bunch. So we need this, just basically these two. Where am I? In here. But not declaring pipeline layout. Interesting. All right. Let's have a go with look what's going on inside here. Oh, actually, I think I already see the problem right there. Yeah, that was the problem right there. I got a little bit of a bug on that one. would Okay. Okay, go in. There we go. Back to this. So we've got this, it generates. Now I need to actually kind of put them in together. So we've got the camera descriptor pool. We're going to have a bunch of. Was would it be array? Probably not. We have a number of buffered frames, much like this vector frame buffer. This. Three. It's not even a good constant. I really want it to be like a const expression or an enum of some sort. Just set to 3. Okay. So if I have one per frame, then I can reset the entire pool every time. Like a linked cameras. can link cameras, we can de-link cameras. So we'll have a vector of cameras as well as we'll have a an array of three or something like that. Standard. And we'll have that standard array of three of these. No, we'll just have the one actually, just the one list. We can clear it every time and rebuild it. Rather, need three. Okay, hold on. Max buffered frames. Buffers for each of the buffered frames, linked cameras, we'll put into a new vector, generate the descriptors, and we reset them every time. But we, okay, so we do need. Frame index. In what we need for that. Yeah, okay. Then we want to generate the buffers. Do we want to actually generate the buffers? No, we don't want to generate them now. We'll generate the descriptor pools though. Nope, not quite gonna find it, even though you did find it earlier. Okay. Pool size stuff. Yes. Had this in here before. There we go. This is what I'm looking for. Uniform buffers count will be equals a 1024, I guess. Max sets basically be the same thing, although that'll be beforehand. To go through, we generate them all. Okay, similarly for destruction or deinitialization, you need to do the opposite. Destroy them. Then we reset. I can't clear it. I can just on the way through make it a reference. Do the same thing for the buffers. Clear it out. Yeah, we gotta destroy them first and Okay. Generating camera descriptors on a frame. So this is a point where, first of all, we have the frame index. Go through all the linked cameras. We also need a vector. Okay. Need the projection times the view data of the camera, so. Projection matrix times, I need to generate like a view matrix. Back to camera. Positional data. Oh, view, positional, but view. Rotate by translate. Orientation for quaternion cast. We'll just base off the identity matrix. Position. Okay. Then once I have this, I need to generate a view descriptor. So, or just the descriptor set. Oh, not the descriptor set layer, just the OK. locate info. There we go. I need the layout. Projection view matrix. Okay, so it is a built-in, so I could actually get it from during initialization. Sure, they start out null as much as possible. Then we're going to be using this. I need a descriptor set to put it into for the moment. Okay, we've created it, and then we have to write it or write to it. So it'll be the buffer info that we'll have. We're going to need to pass in buffer info. Okay, what exactly do I need for VK buffer info? Oh, descriptor buffer info. The buffer, the offset, and the range. Okay. Okay, how many cameras? We know how many cameras we have linked. Okay, so that's actually one thing we're going to have to do first. Is create the buffer if it's, make sure it's the right size. So. Means we're going to need to track the size of cameras count. Max capacity. It's less than that we need to regenerate the buffer. Because we're on the same frame, that means we know we... it's clear for us to destroy, so... this buffer. Okay, then we need to regenerate a new one. No, it does, yeah. Size. Times cameras. Buffer usage. Uniform buffer bit. CPU to GPU. Think of that for a moment. So res equals okay. Let's change this up a little bit. Make it a bit clearer. Offset equals, I don't know, size of, not quite done with this. range equals size of. Okay, we got that. Then we'll write the descriptor set. Wait, no, hold on. That's to be put into the camera. SVK descriptor buffer info. Actually, no, yeah, it would be part of this. That I just generated. I can probably batch these later. Okay, so we created the set, we write to it, we say that it's of this type, in this offset, in this range. We don't even need this then. As long as we need to map this buffer. We map the memory, we have a pointer, and then we could just start writing to it every time we come through a linked camera. I don't actually have a count for this. leaving, we had map memory, of course. Descriptor, we haven't quite put it in yet. Set it there. Set the camera descriptor to that. Okay. Okay, linking and delinking, linking cameras. If we can just put all this into a separate file for the moment, make it a little bit easier. Does not match, really. Ah, yes. Actually, that's another thing. I'm going to require, what was it? From here? The uniform buffer, the offset, the range, destination binding. Yeah, I need the binding. That should be buildable. Almost. Now it should be buildable. Got a few issues. I'm missing. Initialization failed. Now, of course, there may be a case where there's absolutely nothing here. Just returns success. Okay, let's see if we can add this stuff. I'm pretty sure it's more than that. What, 60 degrees? Three high. Actually, no, just leave it at like zero high. Let's move it into the Z direction by 10. Orientation equals GLM quaternion. Use Euler angles. I'm 10 positive, so I need to rotate myself. Actually, no, if I just do that, then set this to like negative 10. Should work. So I'm facing the origin. And we're linked, and then as part of the Vulkan loop. I need to initialize this though. It's basically the last thing here. Pipeline pool, so. Get the layout. It's not the index, it's the binding, isn't it? We need to rename that a little bit. Okay. See how this builds. Okay, actually, that's another thing I need to do while I'm here is that when I come through here. To reset a descriptor pool. Can I not reset the script pools? I thought I could. There's a reset functionality. Oh, there it is. Nope, there's only create. But as part of create, I do need, do I need free to, oh, that's for freeing single ones. Okay. For each one of these things I go through. Okay. So it's going through this every time, right? Oh, I need to reset the capacity. Oh, sorry, I do have actually have a camera, so I am actually setting this every time. Set. Projection, binding, which is in this case 0, but yeah. So we have to put the data in, we unmap it. So we now have it kind of floating around. I kind of need to hook up. Camera is just a little bit better. Linking and delinking. There we go. Sorry, what? All right, it's point pointer. There we go. We delink them. Should mean I should have now have a useful descriptor set. Now I do have this in place. So, what I want to try to do is way down here, bind the pipeline, command draw. Okay, let's try to put this in the old. Same stuff, but what I want to do is instead I want to be able to bind the descriptor, set vk command bind descriptor sets. To this bind pipeline point, the layout of, although the pipeline layout, that makes sense. Let's just lay out. First set is 0. Oh, come on. There we go. There's 1. We have it's what in camera dot set test camera offset count dynamic no none of that. All right, I'm expecting a huge failure here. Or it actually does work. Can't move because I don't have anything hooked to the camera, but it's definitely further away. Supposed to move, okay, other than ignoring all this stuff, if I was to move the camera closer, it gets larger, right? So I am actually doing projection view. Come on. Yes. I actually am. That is good. That is good. So I am actually properly passing at least a uniform buffer in, if nothing else. I'm too close. Oh, no, because the near plane is 2, so I can only be a minimum of 2 away, or 2.1. I don't know. Would it be 2 on the dot or just 2 point something? Okay, I'll just assume 3 then. Right? Z near of 2, I can run 3 units away. I should be able to still see it'll be within 2 planes, right? No? Did I just lose it? Okay. -5. That works, right? Yeah, okay. Leave it at that. I need to go to the destruction of these objects. I have no idea how to decompile stuff for whatever you're trying to do. I'm only a one-way code to compiler, not the other way. Okay, and now I don't no longer have leaks or anything. So everything's probably destroyed at the end of that. Let's see if we can actually put this together a little bit better. Okay, let's try to see if I can do a second camera and see how that compares. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. So we have two cameras. We attach the other one as well. Let's see if adding the second one screws it all up. Or if it still goes through. Should probably, okay, that seems to be fine. And if we change it to be like 10 units away, second camera, it's probably being. Right? Yes. Okay. Now I'm pretty sure I have to do something with alignment for the. Like there's typically a minimum alignment. Now I'm pretty sure between descriptor uniform buffers and stuff that you can have. Right now I'm just assuming that I have a minimum alignment buffer of 64 bytes or less. But it's probably larger on older or on mobile. So I need to just go over the spec for a moment. See precisely what I need. So it's from this something called the VK divis blah da VK. Let me copy that over. This the physical device limits determines where is it? Minimum okay max. Minimum uniform buffer offset alignment. So each offset can offset just down here has to be at least this number of bytes apart each time. Now, I'm probably lucky that I've got an okay graphics card, which has got a small buffer alignment. But I cannot rely on that. So I need to be able to pass it in, I suppose, as part of the graphics environment. Sounds like something that would be pretty useful to have. I got a physical device, so I'll need, like... Yeah, I'll grab this out. Oh, that. Where's the spec? Again, there it is. Come on. There we go. VK, get physical device properties. It's part of the environment's creation. So after we've got the physical device, we queues device. Okay, I'll actually put it as part of the physical device section. So do I really need this other stuff? No, not really. I just really do need the limits. Okay, we got the limits. Now we come back to here. We have environment. Need to do alignment. Let's actually add that. Sorry, what? There we go. Uniform buffer offset alignment. This is the mat. Okay, so we can, since we're only dealing with one type of matrix, 4x4 matrix, I could just do a max between that and that. Just put that in straight up. Which means when we're regenerating the size, so minimum alignment of that times the number of cameras. When we increment the offset, we do it by that. So I'm pretty sure if I actually look at this, is it 64 bytes or less? Or more? No, it can't be more because I already confirmed that it works. It is a 4 byte alignment. Okay, so really good. Oh, actually, I should probably double check that. It's actually, well, no, it's the standard max. That should be fine. Right. Oh. It's just minimized, that's why. Okay. Wait. Rerun. You did. Yeah, 64. Fine. Okay. Okay, let's split this up a little bit. So we got camera, descriptor pool. The right notice at the top. Okay, get the rest of these, put them in the source. Copyright notice at the top of the source. Hmm. has GLM stuff. He does actually have that, so I need... Add that to camera. Not quite. Why? I'm missing the type defs. Okay, created and unloaded without issue. Okay, first, let's start getting some of this stuff back in. So we got this enum, along with that being adding that. This array has, use that instead. So this stuff is just for the camera. Okay. Environment. Okay, can I spell? Minimal maximal alignment. So that's the basic stuff for camera. Now, one thing, what's the time? Hour and a half? Okay, I'm gonna probably end it on that. Next time I'll see if I can actually, because right now for the protect shader, it's kind of all being manually specified. I don't wanna try to get that into a YAML file. I can just load it off the disk every time instead of manually specifying all this stuff for everything basically. This is already what, 700 lines? Yeah, it's getting larger. All right, cheers.